have seen, and you will see.
You don't miss a thing.
a thing. You don't miss a thing. Oh, oh, you don't miss a thing. Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet. My Savior on the cursed tree. His body bound and drenched in tears. Praise his name forever. blazing sun shall pierce the night, and I will rise among the saints. My gaze transfixed on Jesus' face, and oh, praise the joy set before me. else shall I turn to? In my hour of need, whom else shall I turn to? Whom else shall I turn to? Whom else shall I turn to? In the hour of need, whom else shall I turn to? Whom else shall I turn to? Whom else shall I turn to? In the hour of need, whom else shall I turn to? Whom else shall I turn to? Whom else shall I turn to? In the hour of need, whom else shall I turn to? Whom else shall I turn to? Whom else shall I turn to? In the hour of need, I have one refuge. I have one dwelling place, and it's in you. Oh, it's in you. All other homes I found, all they are crushed in.
Shelter. child of the light. For in
fall. For our God is stronger, He can do all things. No higher name we can call, for Jesus is greater. Against Him will fall, for our God is stronger, He can do all things. No higher name we can call, for Jesus is greater. Principality.
No end. Dance through the terror of the night. Oh, I will Testimonies, we will overcome.
to secure the victory. It is enough to secure the victory. It's all because of you, Jesus. It's all because of your love that my soul will live. And it's all because of you, Jesus. It's all because of you, Jesus. It's all because of your love that my soul will live. And it's all because of you, Jesus. It's all because of you, Jesus. It's all because of your love that my soul will live. And it's all
to be like you, give all I have just to know. It's all because of you. It's because of you that we're here today, despite our past, despite our failures. It's because of you we're here today, free from all the chains that you've broken off of us. God, with Jesus, without you, we would be so different. Our lives would be so different. We would still be trapped in darkness. But Jesus, you did what no one else was willing to do. You took our place. You gave your life for us, Jesus. And Jesus, even if no good thing were to happen to us for the rest of our lives, you are still worthy of our praises, Jesus. Because you've done so much for us. And it's because of you. It is because of your great achievement of overcoming the grave, overcoming death, that should be what gives us strength. It's because of you that we can overcome anything. So as we pray for North Korea, as we pray for the believers, we just pray for just to strengthen them. To strengthen them with the same just belief that because you have overcome it all, they can overcome it all as well. In Jesus' name, amen. At this time, we will now transition into a time of prayer and intercession for the believers of North Korea. As I pray, we ask that you come into agreement and then follow in your own intercession. Father, we can't imagine what it's like to be in a place where worshiping you can lead to imprisonment, to torture, to even death. We lift up the believers in North Korea who, despite all those threats, still choose to believe in you and serve you. Even though in those circumstances it's easy to feel fear, we pray that the fear of you overshadows any of the other fears present in the believers in North Korea. And as this fearful awe of you further develops within them, give the believers revelation that you didn't give them a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and self-control, that they don't need to fear anything, even death, because they're putting their trust in the one who's already overcame death, in Jesus Christ. God, no matter how powerful the authorities of North Korea may be, no matter how big the threats, give them a boldness, a steadfast belief like Ephesians 1, that they will know what is the immeasurable greatness of His power towards us who believe, according to the working of His great might that He worked in Christ when He raised Him from the dead and seated Him at His right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age but also in the one to come. And as the fear of the Lord increases within them, we pray Proverbs 19:23 over them. Jesus, let the believers rest satisfied in your presence, under the shadow of your wings, not being visited by harm. Let's pray. Thank you. acknowledge the injustices of the North Korean authorities that's affected the families and lives of many people, especially the North Korean believers who've maybe had their friends or loved ones lose their lives or taken to hard labor camps. We pray even for the believers, whether they're still in hiding or they're imprisoned, that they won't feel any bitterness or desires of revenge towards the authorities or officials who've done them wrong. God, we ask that your love, your supernatural love, quiets the anger within them towards the injustice. We pray that through every unjust action made towards them, every persecution hurled against them, that they will stand the test of faith and wait upon you to bring your justice, that they stand firm knowing the judgment is in your hands, that you will repay. You promise that those who wait for you, those who refrain from anger and forsake wrath, will inherit the land. And let that land not just be referring to their rewards in heaven, but we pray the believers of North Korea will inherit a promised land, a place where they will be able to freely worship you without the threats, without the persecutions. Whatever it takes to bring that forward, whether it's guiding and protecting them and evacuating the country, or reunification where both South and North Korean believers can join arms in praising and glorifying your name. Jesus, our shepherd, guide them to a safe, peaceful haven where they can delight to the full in seeking your presence. Let's pray. Father, when performing our various obligations, our acts of service, we often just go through the motions and lose sight of why we're doing it in the first place. Sometimes we're like the Church of Ephesus. We do all this hard work, endure hardships, show perseverance. We can do seemingly all the right things, but when we forget our love for you, Jesus, all these good deeds don't really mean much. In the case of the believers in North Korea, we pray that they will not fall into this, that they will be taken back to remembering their first love for you. Jesus, take them back to the beginning where they first fell in love with you, when they first encountered you and had that childlike awe and wonder of who you were, restore that childlike curiosity within them. Jesus, we also pray against the enemy's plans to distract the believers from seeking you through hardships or temptations. But Father, just as A.W. Tozer writes, you meant us to see you and live with you and draw our life from your smile. So we ask you, tear down all the distractions, the noise, the chaos of their environment to allow them to fully access your presence. And also we pray that the church in North Korea will be steadfast lovers of you no matter the circumstances. That until your return, Jesus, we prophesy the church will continue to put you first, even through the hardest of difficulties and tribulations, even through the end time shakings, that there will be a church that will not have their lampstand removed. And when you return, Jesus, you will be able to commend them. You will be able to reward them for their love towards you. Let's pray.
stop loving you. I never stop burning for you. I never stop trusting in you.
In North Korea, that their strength and hope will be renewed. Let them remember that you didn't give them a spirit of despair, but a spirit full of strength, anointing, and joy. Restore those who have been weary in their daily efforts to please you. And God, give them the assurance that you are pleased with them. We ask you will pour out your blessings upon the tremendous things they are doing despite the dangerous circumstances they're in. Powerfully answer their prayers and their finances. Powerfully answer their prayers by divine protection, by sending your angels to guard them in all their ways. Let no harm overtake them. Let no disaster come near their tent, just as it is said in Psalm 91. And also we ask for an abundant harvest that they will reap very soon through the many seeds that they have sown in spreading the gospel and building your kingdom, Father. Give them the hope in that abundant harvest, that they will see the fruits of their ministries and the salvations of the people that they've reached out to. Father, bless the believers of North Korea for their faith. Let's pray. what you're doing through the believers in North Korea. It's amazing that despite all the persecution that they face, they still praise your name. They still sing of the goodness of your love. And so God, we just pray that as they are just living their lives for you, we just pray that you will lift their weary heads, that you will, any despair that is within them, we just pray that you will just bring them out of that despair. Any fear that they may have, we just pray that your perfect love casts out all that fear. And Father, we just pray that you will give them the perseverance to just persevere to when you return, Jesus. That Jesus, when you come to return to your bride and you face your bride in the North Korean church, that you will be able to look at every believer with tears in your eyes saying, well done, good and faithful servant. I'm so proud of you. That through it all, you've never stopped yearning for me. Through it all, you've never stopped burning for me. Through it all, you've never stopped loving me. Yeah, Jesus. Your heart burns for the believers in North Korea. Your heart is melted by what they're doing. And we just ask that you'll burn their hearts just the same. We thank you for what you're doing and what you are going to do in North Korea. In Jesus' name, amen.
Death, where is your sting? As dead as my sin, the cross has taught me to live. Mercy, my heart now to say, the day and its trouble shall come. But I know that your strength is enough. Scandal of grace, you died in my place. To be like you, give all I have just to know you. Jesus, there's no one beside you. Forever the hope in my heart. Oh, to be like you, give all I have just to know. There's no one beside you. Forever the hope in my heart. And it's all because of you, Jesus. It's all because of you, Jesus. It's all because of your love that my soul.
Through battles, through persecution, through uncertainty, through fears. You've given us everything it'll take to persevere through it all. We believe in the promise of your word, that those who overcame, they overcame the blood of the Lamb through the word of their testimony. And I pray, Father, that this is the kind of church that you would see rising up, advancing your kingdom, confident in who you are, confident in your strength, your name, your ability to protect, your ability to preserve. All these things, we give you all the glory. We love you, Lord. We thank you. We pray all these things in Jesus' name.